JD, alongside my partner, Matthew, Brian, Shapiro. We've got plenty of action for you tonight, and we're starting things off with some singles competition as Sasha Jenkins makes his way to the ring. To say Sasha Jenkins has had a rough couple of months would be an understatement. Yet Sonya Strong declined his proposal in front of the House of Glory fans. He then teamed with Sonya's nemesis, Violet, only to have her walk away from him mid-match. On top of that, he watched his opponent lay a kiss on the woman that he loved. Sasha Jenkins looks to take his frustrations out on the smooth operator, Big Daddy Cruz, next on House of Glory.
And JD, in our main event, two of the hardest hitting wrestlers in our sport today, Alberto El Patron takes on Low-Ki right here tonight on HOG Live.
Ring the bell!
You know what I think we gotta do, Shapiro? We gotta go out to the club after tonight and have Big Daddy Cruz walk down to the club with that theme and that outfit that he just came out with.
You know, when I first walked into House of Glory, the first man I managed was Big Daddy Cruz.
Oh my God! I think Sasha Jenkins is treading thin water there.
But that's the Big Daddy Cruz I walked into House of Glory with. Not this smooth operator. Not this lover. You know, as soon as the killer gets some good, that makes it everything change, JD.
Big Daddy Cruz, a monster of a man. Look at that! A hurricanrana!
I will say a lot of things about Big Daddy Cruz. Not a lot of them good, but I will admit he is a high caliber athlete when he wants to.
Now you know why he came out the smooth operator. That was a beautiful move. Stalking Jenkins on the outside, throws him right into the steel. Elmcore Center.
A near capacity crowd here in Corona. House of Glory's debut here.
Oh my God. Big Daddy Cruz miscalculated that one. Clothesline to steal, and then he goes head first. That could be the opening Jenkins needs.
It could be, and Sasha Jenkins is another high caliber athlete, someone who has a lot of athletic ability, a lot of skill, but once again is wrapped up in his own self-involvement, thinking that he's the best thing to ever happen to society since sliced bread and digital television. But he's not. He's a cuck. He cucked himself several times. And he's got to de-cuck himself here. Great offense by Jenkins on the outside.
He just threw Big Daddy Cruz out into the steel, but that's the way you got to be, Shapiro. You got to have that confidence. You got to have that bravado. In House of Glory especially. There's, you know how much competition he's going to be.
There's a difference between confidence, bravado, and braggadocio and whatever it is Sasha Jenkins has. And I like Sasha Jenkins. But he's someone who's 5 cents away from a full dollar.
Now, I don't know why he is just taking his time with Big Daddy Cruz. He's got the guy, you know, he's got him where he needs to be. Well, I guess not anymore. Look at that.
Woo! There is...
Look at an arm breaker off of the rope.
But at ringside, there's a... I don't know who those people are, but a dashing young couple has come out to ringside and there's...
looks like they're taking notes.
They are, and I go back to the action, I guess, but I cannot stop looking at those two beautiful people. Like, I'm entranced.
And we don't know what business they have being out here or what their reason for being out here is, as Jenkins drops that leg drop right across the arm and follows up with a knee. He's got Big Daddy Cruz right where he wants him. Are they scouting for House of Glory? Are they scouting Sasha Jenkins?
They could be scouting Sasha Jenkins. They could be scouting Big Daddy Cruz. Even though I left a negative review on his Yelp page, people still may want broken goods. Hell, people talk to you.
Sasha Jenkins now. He's got Big Daddy Cruz lying on his back. That's what you want.
You've got to keep on Big Daddy Cruz. You need to wear away.
Wow, what a move there.
And that will take away from what he now calls the C4, formerly known as the Cruz Missile. That fireman's carry. That Spicoli driver into the turnbuckle.
And now Sasha Jenkins with that armbar. Trying to wear down Big Daddy Cruz.
Need to get a man like Big Daddy Cruz down. You need to isolate a body part. You need to wear away at him. You need to stay on Big Daddy Cruz. You cannot allow him to breathe for a second.
Big Daddy Cruz fighting back to a vertical base now with those shots right to the gut. Jenkins pulls the hair. I mean, it's not legal, but it works. Up and over. Lands on his feet. Sasha Jenkins met with that elbow. Cruz now on the offensive. Another elbow. That's Jenkins really. Right on the ring apron here, right in front of us, and a big boot by Jenkins. Big Daddy Cruz dazed.
Once again, going for that arm, JD, isolating it off the top.
Nice move there. That's a nice move by Sasha Jenkins.
Trying to separate the shoulder, trying to dislocate the elbow, bringing that weight onto the top rope, and that is elevator cable. So you know it's just dropping on it. There's not a lot of give. There's not a lot of resistance, especially coming from the top.
Sasha Jenkins tuning up the band here. What is he doing? Right through the ropes. Big Daddy Cruz catches him.
Like a baby.
Oh, my God.
Belly
to back suplex.
Just tossed him right over head. Over the head, belly to belly.
And that's hardwood floor, Shapiro.
Yeah, there's not a lot of give here.
The action never stops, but we've got to take a break. We'll be back with more. This is House of Glory Wrestling.
You're not going to get into a fist fight with Big Daddy Cruz. This is where Sasha Jenkins needs to realize he is at a disadvantage.
I'm your biggest fan right now.
A sidewalk slam. One, two. And Jenkins picks out. You got to give it to him.
I'll give it to him. He kicked out at two, but that was more muscle memory than anything. That was just him, like, hearing the count and like, oh, I have to kick out now. He might be out on his feet.
Big Daddy Cruz now setting Sasha Jenkins on the top turnbuckle and a slap right across the face by Jenkins. Measuring him. Blockbuster neck breaker! Holy cow!
This one could be up!
One, two! How the hell did Big Daddy Cruz kick out of that?
Not an effective cover JD, hooked the leg, but didn't put any pressure on the shoulders. Gave that whole upper body enough room to move.
A blockbuster neck breaker. That would put any normal man away, but Big Daddy Cruz is back to his feet.
And Sasha Jenkins needs to get his eyes off a crooked referee, Luisito Jr.
Went for that big lariat. There's that C4!
Clothesline, a lariat and a half. Explosive. Explosive fire, number one!
What the fuck, Jimmy?
I think Jenkins' head just went into the third row. Two, three.
That's it.
Jimmy, you get the point.
The winner of this match, the smooth operator, Big Daddy Cruz.
Sasha Jenkins put up a fight, Shapiro. Big Daddy Cruz. He put up an even bigger one. Stands victorious after that huge lariat.
Well, Sasha Jenkins, like many of his dates, they put up a fight, and at the end, he didn't get lucky. But Big Daddy Cruz, the smooth operator, getting away with a victory here tonight.
Coming up next in a tag team match, two teams I know very well and I despise very much. The Super Savages try to take the HOG tag team titles from EYFBO right here on HOG Live.
Super Savage!
Ladies and gentlemen, we are underway.
I hate these people.
Shapiro, we got written ring action. Come on.
We do. It's the House of Glory tag titles. The TYFBO against the Super Savages.
The Super Savages won an online poll to be in this match, get the opportunity tonight for the World Tag Team titles of House of Glory.
Yeah, so did our president. That doesn't make it valid.
Okay, man.
Why are you looking at my feet for, man?
And Angel Ortiz.
This is a wrestle. I'm going to put your head
to start the match.
He's biting him. He's biting him.
Fireman's carry takeover there by Ortiz.
You know, I don't like either of these teams. I dislike them greatly. If they were set on fire, I wouldn't put them out, even if I was on fire. But I have to respect the talent of both of these teams. Begrudging.
Arm drag off the rope there, float over into a pinning combination there. 2.5 there by Ortiz.
Angel
Don't turn your back on Caveman.
Angel Ortiz is one of the most dynamic men I've ever seen in pro wrestling for all the bravado and all the insipid behavior.
EYFBO World Tag Team titles and House of Glory's biggest main event ever at House of Glory 6, Fatal 4-Way. Hardys, the Dudleys, and Private Party.
In a match that defined two generations of tag team wrestling, EYFBO walked out the winner.
What a backbreaker by Ortiz.
Gut wrench.
Into a side slam. EYFBO in complete control so far.
The power man of the team, Angel Ortiz. But one thing to note, JD, EYFBO two-time champions, but have never successfully won, maintained, and retained the tag titles by pinfall or submission.
That is true, Shapiro. And they have a lot of teams gunning for them, I'll tell you that right now.
He took his shoe. He took his stupid, stupid shoe.
High drastic in the ring now. Ortiz without a shoe.
It's not the first time he's been without his shoe.
No, a caveman, he'll probably eat the shoe.
Probably.
Oh my God! Itsugori does no damage.
Just drastic suffers fools light. Doesn't suffer fools lightly. And while these two teams have teamed up before against my clients, I might add, it is a completely different mindset when you stand across the ring from EYFBO.
Shoulder tackle there, gloating in front of Drastic. Action's quick, action's fast. Springboard. The electric chair position here.
The Super Savages make me wish the death penalty was still legal.
Look at that arm drag, beautifully done by Monte.
Monte. Another wrestler, smooth as butter.
Drastic got a corner kick to the face. Action's all over the place. Tilt-a-whirl here. Head scissor takedown.
That threw me off balance, JD. And this is the situation that champs do not want to be in.
Double team here by the Super Savages.
You wouldn't expect a team of a superhero and a caveman to do well, but yet again, I thought Parenthood would would be canceled after one season. I don't know much.
Angel Ortiz now working on both men. A succession of chops and straight right to the face.
Language!
Oh my God.
Why I don't think the Super Savages will be as successful as other people say they are. They don't take this opportunity seriously.
What a kick by Drastic here. Huge suplex! Beautifully done by my Drastic.
Drastic, the more serious of the two, the more violent of the two.
Bummer. Capacity crowd here at the NYC Arena. With Glory comes Pride. Tag team title fight to open this great card tonight.
It is a big card. Reborn Matt Sydal here, our main event. A dream between Alberto El Pacho and low key cover.
Almonte gets his left shoulder up there.
The champ's taking the challenges a little too lightly there, not pressing down on the shoulders, not hooking that outside leg. That might have cost the champ the tag titles, but Drastic concussion kick.
Huge knife edge shot by Mike Drastic. Oh my God, what a shot to the face.
I ain't gonna say he's a bitch, but he just got slapped like one.
Back suplex by Mike Drastic.
And this is the opportunity where you see how good EYFBO is. As a unit, as individual wrestlers, they break down opponents, they find that one little weakness, and they exploit it until they can't move no more.
My Drastic on the rush headlock here. Knee digging right into the small of the back of Monte. Caveman trying to get this crowd going. Angel Ortiz in now, and the double team begins. Keeping Monte in there, pushing up the ring. And Monte, look at that, rolls to the outside. Caveman, springboard, crossbody.
Savages,
idiots.
Look at this, Monte into Ortiz on the outside. Spinning back kick there by Monte. Caveman still on the outside. He's fighting this one 2-on-1.
Both men down. Dead center of the ring. JD, this is the opportunity the Super Savages need. They need to get up. Monte needs to get up and isolate Drastic. Caveman needs to find a way right now to muster energy, any energy he has, and win this match for the Savages.
Now look at Goofy from Nash Shapiro. It's 2-on-1 against the tag champs. He makes the tag to Caveman.
Waiting for
a headbutt. Ortiz and gets a headbutt.
It's like running full on into a cinder block.
No headbutts here. Caveman's on a hot streak. He's a madman.
At some point, you just gotta stay down.
Look at this, Shapiro. He's got both. And that stopped him. He had both men all by himself. Super Savages win the tag titles tonight.
The light almost went out of Drastic's eyes. Big headbutt.
Making a case for it. Two. Heartbeat away from new champions.
Yet again, taking the opponent too lightly. You think that the big impact move's going to get it done, but you need to do everything you can without killing the man to try to get the pinfall and the victory.
Super Savages have to continue this momentum. They cannot waste any time against the tag team champions right now. Angel Ortiz is in trouble here. BYFBO is in danger of losing those tag team titles. Monte. Monte off the top. Hedges is off the top. Hurricane Rana. Splash by Caveman! Caveman with a big splash! Saves the day, saves the titles.
And that might have been the, oh my god.
A super kick to the face. Power bombs Caveman right into Monte.
Suck me ball!
BYFBO here looking to finish it off. Looking to finish it off here.
Here it comes.
The toughest, most outspoken, and most dedicated wrestlers in our sport today, Mexico's greatest export, Alberto El Patron, takes on Low Key when we return right here on HOG Live.
Next episode of HOG Live. Kick off the summer with an adrenaline rush as we air HOG Adrenaline in its entirety throughout the month of June. Watch HOG Live Fridays at 8 p.m. on Facebook Live.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to take a quick break, but don't go anywhere. We've got some more great action coming up. This is House of Glory.
Export of Mexico against one of the toughest men ever to walk through the streets of Brooklyn. It's Low Ki and Alberto El Patron in our main event here tonight. And someone's gonna get hit really hard in the face, and it's gonna be, well, it's not gonna be me, it might be him.
If you wanna fight, this is the match that we're all gonna be watching.
Bon Scott once said, if you want blood, you got it. And if you wanted violence, you came to the right wrestling show. Let's go. Let's throw down in the words of Ed Whalen. It's a ring-a-dang-doo-dandy. Let's go to the ring, ring the bell, and let's get the fight.
Here we go. Low Ki, a product of New York, Brooklyn, to be exact.
Came out of the doghouse. Came out of the same school as Homicide, the Hit Squad. A family. A family all its own. But Alberto El Patron, a third generation star, his uncle Mil Mascaras, himself Dos Caras, his father, Dos Caras Sr.
So many accomplishments between both men. Low Ki, a veteran of almost 20 years. Three-time IWGP Junior Heavyweight Champion. Inaugural Ring of Honor Champion. Three-time NWA Tag Team Champion, Del Rio. Better known for his work in WWE. Held the WWE and World Heavyweight Championships on two different occasions.
Has done almost everything you could do in the sport of pro wrestling.
Won the 2011 Royal Rumble. 2011 Money in the Bank in the same year. Only man to do that, ever. And they shake hands. And here we go.
Earlier today, I was scouting at the Alberto El Patron seminar. And the passion and dedication this man has for pro wrestling can rarely be matched. And I think the man standing across the ring from him can match that. And this crowd on fire before these two men have even struck each other.
Fans anticipate the kind of match we're going to get, Shapiro. Low Ki, pound for pound, one of the toughest men you've ever seen.
Last time we saw him here in House of Glory was this past August during High Intensity. Roll through by Low Ki. It's like watching Garry Kasparov and Bobby Fischer play chess. It's like watching Bird play magic. It's two masters of our industry standing off here tonight. Isolating that arm.
He's got the arm. He's going for that arm.
Went for the hammerlock. He's going to try to go for that arm breaker. A man who has experience not only in wrestling but in mixed martial arts. Low Ki the same. One of the most devastating strikers in the history of our industry.
Low Ki rolls through.
Still a feeling out process between both men.
A lot of people denigrate wrestling, JD. A lot of people look down on our sport. But these two men help it rise to an art form.
Absolutely. These two are the definition of why we all love professional wrestling.
Working on that arm is Low-Key. Wrist lock applied. Trying to fight out of it. It's a third generation star from Mexico.
Look at that Del Rio. Look
at. Now isolating that arm and that shoulder. A lively crowd here tonight in Queens. I hate these people, but I love the energy. Low-Key trying to take him out.
The dropkick by Low-Key.
A lot of people talk about educated feet, JD. Not only does Low-Key have educated feet, but they have master's PhDs, double PhDs. I think they own their own college somewhere in Brunswick. This crowd kind of split between the hometown boy and the visitor.
What a shot by El Patron. Very split. Beautiful snap suplex.
Beautiful
float over.
Only a one count, but a one count still effective. I'm surprised these people can count Spanish, let alone English.
Tell you what, they do better than me.
Ow.
When you talk about picks, Shapiro, El Patron's got some of the most devastating you will ever see.
And now Alberto El Patron coming out near us. And this is not a fight that either man wants to take to each other on the outside.
He goes right into the steel. Low-Key counted that nicely.
Not a lot of give. Oh,
right in front of us
here. Oh, boy. Oh, Lord.
Oh, my God.
His face going right into the table. El Patron, oh, Low-Key rolling right out and coming right back towards us here.
To El Patron in trouble here.
Good Lord.
Headbutt by Low-Key.
And you can see that reel to Low-Key a little bit. Devastating.
I felt that sitting over here. One.
Only a one count.
Talk about in your face. Low-Key with another knife edge shot. Irish whip now. Alberto Alvarez reverses it. Low-Key. Kicks him away. Look at that. Now Low-Key. With those stiff forearms.
Low-Key, come on, man.
Set up. There's only trouble at the top. Look at this. Look at this. Shapiro's got the armbar. Draped over that top rope. Utilizing the referee's 10 count.
Effective strategy there by El Patron.
Measuring Low-Key. Kick right to the chest.
Devastating, could crack a rib.
Cover.
And you can see Low-Key trying to shake the kinks out of that arm, that left arm. Takes the elbow pad off, which kind of exposes it a little bit more, JD.
That is El Patron's strategy here, work on that arm. Set up for that cross arm break. Devastating finishing maneuver.
Clobbers him with the chop. One more.
You can see the redness developing on El Patron's chest from those knife-edge shots. What a clothesline! What a clothesline by Alberto El Patron. Loki is now.
Loki's a perro. Loki's a perro.
And this is a two-way offense here. Defending that, going against that arm, JD. Not only trying to go for that cross arm breaker, but also trying to avoid the key crusher.
That key crusher is absolutely devastating. And Loki can deliver it in a multitude of ways.
And you need both arms to pull it off. And if you have that left arm completely isolated, big press.
The strength of Alberto El Patron. Gorilla press slam here. Into a German release suplex.
And Key still in defensive position, but down.
Contest, both men have beaten each other so badly so far.
Nearing the 10-minute mark of this epic encounter. Referee Luisino Jr. just checking up on both men. And then a buckle.
Another clothesline by Alberto El Patron there. Both feet down, he's going for the cover. Wisely, count only.
Someone call that a 1.5. Trying to get him up into that top rope.
Everyone knows how dangerous Loki is. Buckling everything can. Now on top. Top turnbuckle here. Super flex off the top.
Devastating right into the dead center of that ring. Calling his shot like his name was Bobby Thompson.
There is Shapiro. He was going for that cross arm breaker.
Cross over.
Loki. Look at that.
Beautiful bridge. Beautiful bridge.
Loki was aware. Had that one well scouted there. That cross arm break. Loki getting.
Sometimes when you play the crowd a little too much, you expose yourself. And when you go against a man like Loki, you do not want to do that. Into the ropes.
Look at that. Loki with the cover.
Loki.
Roundhouse kick off the top, Shapiro. So dangerous.
Loki can kick you from any which way he can move. That is the devastating thing about the 19-year-old veteran from Brooklyn.
Trying to. Jockey with position now in the corner.
Now El Patron up on that top rope, JD.
Key crusher. Might be going for the key crusher, Spiro.
Battling out of it from that fireman's carry. Backstab!
Backstab by it! Patron!
Hooks it.
One, two. Two count only on Low King.
Forces his way out there.
El Patron, seen that key crusher coming.
Both of these men have faced some of the same opponents. Both of them have faced against CM Punk. Both of them have stood across the ring from some of the greatest of all time in our industry, and both of these could be put in that class.
Right above us here. Loki's in a tree of woe right now.
He's got one leg loose though, JD. He's got one leg loose. He's trying to get that other one out. Trying to get that left leg out.
El Patron going for that double foot stomp, possibly Shapiro. If he nails that, it could be over. No.
Reversal.
For a second, I thought he was going for the key crusher off the top.
Loki, do that thing I taught you. Yeah, elbow in the half. Punch in the half. Then you're
gonna finish. Both men fighting right above us here. Loki now.
On to the apron.
Lands on his feet. Springboard. Hurricanrana!
Goes for the cover!
Al Patron gets his left shoulder up.
I don't know how he was able to kick out there. Going for a dragon sleeper.
Going for that dragon sleeper, then that dragon clutch. That's what he calls that. That drowsy dragon sleeper.
He's trying to get his arms over the head of Alberto El Patron.
Why not, though? Alberto El Patron back to the vertical base here. Great ring awareness, knew the turnbuckle was right behind him.
Drives him into that turnbuckle.
Right there. There again, he's working on that arm. El Patron set him up now.
Super kick!
There's that kick!
And he is furious. He is looking at our senior official, Luis Zeno Jr., and looking to take his head off.
There's a laundry list of opponents that that kick has put away. Shapiro low-key kicks out of it. Waist lock.
Flipped out!
There's that double foot stomp! Warrior's way, double foot stomp. Only a two count.
That major double foot stomp when he goes up top, that's when you call for the Warrior's way, but that foot stomp effective nonetheless, JD. Could have been all.
Low key positions, Alberto El Patron on the top rope. Uh-oh. This is what they call the Warrior's wrath, Shapiro. If he nails it, it could be over.
It could be more than over. They get sent Alberto El Patron's lungs into Jackson Heights.
Beautiful counter. Grabs the tights, pulls him down.
Cross
the
right breaker. In the middle of the ring.
We got it.
Perfect positioning. Perfect positioning.
Nowhere to go for low key.
He taps out.
He taps out. Low key taps out. To the cross breaker. Wow.
Because with two Warriors step into that ring, magic happens, JD, and that is magic in our sport.
An unbelievable main event. Low key taps out to the cross-arm breaker. Shapiro, I'm in shock.
When you come in with a game plan, you stick to that game plan, and you find that one moment of weakness, that grain of sand inside the memory of a computer. The machine breaks down, and the Patron will defeat the Warrior. Ladies and gentlemen, this has been House of Glory, where glory comes pride. That's JD from New York. I'm Matthew Ryan Shapiro. We'll see you in April. Too sweet me, trust me, suck me. We'll see you in April.
Gentlemen, thank you so much for watching. Join us next week when we will have more action right here from House of Glory.